The following is from NIT, National Instructional Television.
What are people afraid of? Why do people make pictures of disease, war, and famine, things they fear? Sometimes artists use their works to open doors in their minds, to express their fears, as someone else might scream. In most societies, artists use their skills to help other people manage their fears. Though Nigeria is a very modern African country, there are still those who preserve old ways. To help other people deal with their fears, artists there make images of the god Shango and his wives. Believers who think that someone is plotting against them prepare to visit the shrine of Shango. They will ask Shango to call down his vengeance on their enemies. they must prepare themselves by putting on a special makeup made of the ground bark of the cam tree. This camwood makeup is sacred to the god Shango. Shango was an evil king and magician. When he died, some people refused to believe he was dead. They felt he had magically entered the earth as a force of nature. They believed Shango controlled thunder and lightning, and that he could be called upon to protect them from evil. A believer who needs Shango's help goes to honor the figures at his shrine. Oil, fruit, and kola nuts must be brought for sacrifice. Shango's vengeance comes with a storm. Of the United States and Canada, some groups still follow ancient beliefs in the power of masks. A person who becomes sick, or who dreams of the masks, can expect the masks to help him. When disease plagues the settlements, believers wearing the masks pass among the people, frightening disease out of those who are stricken. No one laughs at the false faces, for they believe that the masks can cause the same illness which they cure. People wearing masks blow live coals on the sick to frighten disease away. A believer, it is said, will not be harmed when he puts his hand in the fire to gather burning coals to blow on a sick person. Oriental art has preserved a thousand-year-old legend that has helped many people deal with their fears. The legend says that the Emperor of China became ill with a fever and fell asleep. While dreaming, he thought he saw the demon of emptiness and devastation enter the palace. Suddenly, a huge figure appeared and chased the demon from the palace. The emperor asked the figure its name. Sheng Kuei, he replied. When the emperor woke, he made the spirit of Sheng Kuei official demon chaser of the Chinese Empire. There are many artworks that tell the story of Sheng Kuei. This is a 700-year-old scroll painting of Sheng Kuei and his sister out on a demon hunt. At the end of the scroll are notes by many people who have seen it. They say that they had been troubled by bad dreams, but that after seeing the scroll, they were able to sleep peacefully, without trouble from the demons of the night. Celebration of each new year in Chinese communities, a figure representing Sheng Kuei dances through the streets, frightening demons from shops and homes. That are not yet clearly understood, things people make can be a great psychological help to others in dealing with fear. It happens among African, American Indian, and Chinese peoples. In fact, it happens all over the world, where men have carved monsters and frightening animals to scare the things they fear away from their temples and homes. Somehow, people have felt safer with a guard of stone, wood, or bronze at their front door. They have designed armor, helmets, and uniforms to put fear into their enemies and confidence into themselves. Christian artists also deal with good and evil. They create objects which symbolize a supernatural goodness which has the power to protect men from evil. Unseen enemy is the worst kind. Artists can help by giving fears a face and arousing people to action. Art can be used as a weapon. It can select one symbol to represent millions of enemies. Sometimes people use art to make their enemies seem ridiculous. certain forms of art are created just for the pleasure we take in being scared. Of scary things, small and easy to handle. Things that are made to scare us on purpose.
This Images and Things program was produced by the Northern Virginia Educational Television Association for NIT, National Instructional Television, in association with a consortium of 26 educational agencies.